Elizabeth Helen Blackburn was born November 26, 1948, on the island of Tasmania in Australia. She knew that there were science genes present inside of her because both of her parents were family physicians and certainly encouraged her interest in science. At a young age, she loved animals and nature. Her great-grandfather and grandfather were both geologists. For her education, Blackburn attended the University of Melbourne in Australia and studied biochemistry. Then she received her PhD from Cambridge University in England. It was at Cambridge where she met her husband. Outside of work, Elizabeth Blackburn enjoys playing the piano and doing Sudokus. However, she has been quoted saying, "People who love their work don't need hobbies. Work is your hobby." The field of science that this scientist focuses on is biochemistry and genetics, and she loves science because it is endlessly interesting and loves surprises. Genes interact in totally unexpected ways, and she loves the way that the science of biology and the tools and the technologies are changing because there are so many unanswered questions, and you can bring in new technologies to apply them. Blackburn's main focus of research is telomeres, and she has made many discoveries. In 1980, Elizabeth Blackburn discovered that telomeres have a particular DNA. Then, in 1982, with the help of another scientist named Jack Czaszostak, she further proved that this DNA prevents chromosomes from being broken down. Then, a couple of years later, in 1984, she and a different scientist named Carol Greider discovered the enzyme telomerase, which is a protein that produces the telomere's DNA. In 2009, she received a Nobel Prize for her findings. More specifically, she won the Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicine for the discovery of how chromosomes are protected by telomeres and the enzyme telomerase. More recently, Blackburn has taken an interest in the ethical implications of research and has contributed to the creation of a code regulating the field. Also, her most recent publication was for a paper about telomere length in newborns. This research was about the first evidence that prenatal inflammation potentially programs newborns' telomeres. For this study, participants were healthy women recruited in early pregnancy. Maternal blood samples were taken for early, mid, and late pregnancy for each of the patients, and the telomere length was assessed in newborns' blood samples soon after birth. The results included in her paper were that there is now new evidence in humans for potential programming mechanisms linking maternal systematic pro-inflammatory processes during pregnancy with the initial length of the offspring's telomeres. What I admire most about this scientist is that she never let the fact that she was a woman deter her from being successful. In her undergraduate education, she had to overcome obstacles because some of her professors treated her differently for her gender. However, she did not let that affect her success in any way.